5 hours of summer once a week. Hey, 5 hours of summer one Saturday morning.
All right, it is time once again for yet another episode of Color Commentary, where we give you views from a different side. This, of course, is your host, Rashad. I'm joined by my compadre, Mr. Chuck Taylor.
Chuck Taylor here, guys. Yes, it's been a little while, but we have a great show for you guys. Make sure you like and subscribe. We'll be all in your lives. Can't wait to talk about this one.
As you can see, both Chuck and I are Black Suit Spider-Man. This is we're Black Suit Spider-Man without the symbiote. This is just, you know, what he would wear if he decided to wear a black suit. He would just be some long johns. Guys, it's going to be a great show because we're talking about Spider-Man. No Way Home. Spider-Man. I'll just say a fantastic movie. Oh, man, it's amazing. It's amazing. I will go ahead and start it out by talking about what I didn't like in this movie. I just go ahead and get it out the way. Yeah, somebody didn't like.
He didn't like something.
This is a spoiler review, by the way, y'all. So, we're about to spoil it right now. The only thing, if I could improve anything on this movie, it would only be one thing. They could have used a little age de-aging for Mr. McGuire when he first showed up. He's looking a little old. Look a little old, bro. I was like, Andrew was looking like, okay, Andrew looks good. Like he's been working out. He looks like basically just like Spider-Man. And they called him Youth Pastor Spider-Man. Yeah. Tobey's seen some things, but that's it. That is my only complaint. I literally cannot think of anything else about this movie I could improve upon. So what about you, Mr. Chuck Taylor? Do you have anything that needed some help? Let's get the dislikes out the way, because I know we got a lot of likes.
Yeah, we got a lot of likes. So I've seen this movie probably about 4 times now.
Wow.
2 in theaters, and then I saw, you know, a couple of personal versions. But, versions. You know, well, not personal, but you know what I mean. Uh-huh. But yeah, the movie to me is so good. But I guess the only thing I would say, I don't really know how they would make this better, because you need this part of the movie to kind of, you know, develop everything else, you know, so it all comes to pass in the middle and end of it. But the beginning part of the movie, it's just a little unorganized, just tightly at the beginning. So sometimes, like after watching it a couple times, you kind of just want to move past that part to right when they start to get their letters of a cancellation. The letters of denial, so they can't go to school. Uh-huh. So the stuff all the way before that is not saying it's not necessary for the movie, but something just seems like it's just not. It doesn't make it smooth right to that first main, I guess, decision making.
You've been listening to Clyde. That's the
only thing he said. That was the only thing that after watching him. When you're in theaters, like you had those little moments. It's like I think even when I was a little bit late to get to him, it was like, oh, we didn't miss anything, guys. This is all that happens on this part. All right, go sit down. We're good. And the real movie hasn't started yet. So, but to me, I think that's why I say it's kind of like that stuff is still needed, because you need that type of conflict of how crazy his life is.
Okay.
And then, you know, seeing a reason why he would go to Doctor Strange, you know, for, you know, that type of spell, you know. So, but to me, I think they could have did it a little bit differently just to kind of make that, you know, perfect. They could have written that a little bit better, but, you know, each is on. Still a great movie with that one out that first 20 minutes. You know, it'd be
okay,
a little bit better, but
the
movie was great.
All right, well, we got the dislikes out the way. Let's go ahead and get them likes in. It's gonna be many, many, many
likes.
I don't even know how we're gonna do this, because like I could just talk straight. about this movie forever. I'm sure you could do the same
thing.
Well,
I do it like we used to, like the top three moments or something. I think we used to do that like back in.
I got a lot more than three. So how about you just give me three and then I'll do three and then we'll just see what happens.
Okay. All right. So for my top three moments, I really enjoyed the battle with Doctor Strange. Like seeing Spider-Man, it really made Spider-Man that type of moral character. Like, wow, he's really like he like got that Jesus type thinking, almost like, you know, sacrifice yourself to help other people all the time.
Right.
No matter what, you know, you see the good in people. I'm like, bruh, send them people back.
Right.
Like, that's what I'm saying in the theaters, but he's like, no, I have a heart. Strange takes the thing, they start fighting, knocks him out of his body, and then he can't get the box without the
cool.
Spider senses, like making him, you know, move it and stuff. I thought that was really cool. Then he figures out how to trap him into the mirror dimension, you know, with geometry. I was like, oh, okay, this is really clever how they did that, using Spider's, you know, science, his brain, his math. You know, because he is a math whiz and science whiz, so kind of, they definitely showed that a lot on this movie. So that whole fight scene, and then how they closed out Doctor Strange throughout the whole movie. So like, I mean, thinking like, okay, let's talk about multiverse. So probably Doctor Strange gonna be here all day, but nah, like he literally came in this thing, and you didn't see him to the end of the movie.
Right,
like,
exactly.
They wrapped that up real quick.
I've been here for 12 hours at least. Now he knows how Loki feels. I've been falling for 30 minutes.
Yeah, Loki, 30 minutes. But the next one definitely has to be I'm not gonna say just the Aunt May scene. It's like the when he takes the villains and he's trying to fix them and stuff, and he fixes Doc Ock and. Green Goblin. What's the name of the guy that plays him?
William DaFoe.
Oh my gosh, he is amazing. Like, he is amazing. Like, the way he portrays Green Goblin, like, you really think that he's like kind of changed, to be honest with you. Then you just you see you know, Peter have his tingle going on. Oh, something's going on. He's looking at all the villains. You know, he's like, May, where you at? Like, he's got to figure out what's going on. And then he just comes outside, just throws out the web all the boy. He's like that. And his voice just changes. Oh, Peter, that tingle, or no, that sense. You know, he just starts just talking.
Right.
And he's just like, I'm like, golly, this is amazing. And that fight scene, they're like fighting through the floor. He's like doing suplexes on him.
He's hitting as hard as he can.
Yeah, he basically did the Black Widow on a Winter Soldier thing off of Civil War. And then they just slam him down.
Right.
Like, basically, it wasn't even hurt him. He was smiling like crazy. I'm like, that dude is amazing as an actor. I'm like, that part was amazing. And then seeing May die, death scene was pretty tragic. Like, because she got up, she walked around, she was gone. Okay, so she's not dead. So,
May's straight.
I'm like, are they going to do this again? She's not dying. But then she gave the line. And everybody feels like, we know what happens when someone
Don't say that, May.
With great power comes great responsibility.
Right.
Boom. That's your moment right there. And I was like, damn. So seeing Peter's whole, you know, him trying to battle his emotions, trying to still stay pure and not go off the deep end was cool. And last but not least, probably definitely my favorite moment of the movie was when your boy MCU Spider-Man was trying to end Goblin's life, like serious in his life. Like he came.
Well, no, Jesus moment there.
Down. He was like, yeah, I ain't holding back no punches no more. Now you gonna feel these hits. You gonna feel all of this. And then he picks up that the Goblin's thing. He comes at him. Like, you think, like, okay, something's going to happen. He's not going to actually try to kill him.
Right.
You know, because, like, you don't think, it's not going to kill him in cold blood. But, I probably would have been hurry up and try to kill him, too. No,
what's his name? John Walker? John Walker.
Yeah. And Tobey comes in there and catches it and holds it and just like stares at him. Like they're like having that kind of, and Peter's just screaming, trying to get that rage through. And it's like cool because Tobey's like saving both of them. He's not just saving Goblin, he's saving Peter too.
Right.
Because he knows if Peter goes over that edge, that it might not be no coming back for him. Like his whole Spider-Man persona is gone. Like he is a murderer now, and he's
right.
is going to eat at him throughout you know, his life and stuff. So those are like my top three, like, you know, moments of the movie.
Yeah, I would agree with a lot of those scenes. I'll start with that one right there. You know, it's a lot of, when we watch movies, it's very easy for us to say, oh yeah, man, I would have killed him, you know, that type of stuff. Because, you know, some superheroes are like that. And that's kind of how the movie is set up. But in real life, like what it takes to actually murder another human being. All right, that's a big deal. That's a really, really big deal, you know, regardless of what was done to you, you know, to take another life, you know. And so I'm glad that Tobey Maguire was there in order to stop him from doing that. Now, I wish that Tom hadn't made the decisions that he made in order to make that necessary. It's a lot of messing up. A lot of messing up that got to that point, you know, so... Yeah, but I'm glad he didn't have to be a murderer. Let me see here. And then what you were just talking about with the scene where he had the spider sense and he was in the room. That was an amazing scene.
Yeah,
it was with the villains. Nice. All of a sudden, it just hit him. And he's just walking around and everybody's following him like, what's going on? He's like,
why are you looking at me like that? Right. You know, Jamie, he was like, what you looking at me like that? Jamie was so funny, bro. Jamie was so good in this movie, man. Yeah. I enjoyed him so much.
It's gotta be a black Spider-Man somewhere.
Are those your Legos? I'm like, he's just been coming out with stuff.
But I love
the whole open floor plan vibe, bro.
Yeah, but when he shot Green Goblin, you know, that was awesome at that happy place there. All right, I guess a couple scenes that I really like. I really like seeing Spider-Man swing on the power lines. It was such a small part, but we don't get a chance to see him do that. We mainly see him, you know, swinging in New York or recently swinging in other parts of Europe and stuff. But like when he's going a long distance and swinging on the power lines and how that looked and how the music was right there, I thought it looked great. You know, I wasn't expecting to really like that part. Let me see here. You said a lot of the stuff that I like the fight scene between Spider-Man and Doctor Strange. And I really said, let me just go with this. I like this movie a lot because it really gave Tom Holland his due. It was Tom Holland's movie. And there was a lot of people in this movie. I mean, you get five villains, two other Spider-Men. Mm-hmm. It was very easy for him to be overshadowed in this movie, but they really pushed him and put him up to the front. You know, so one of the things was, just like you said, him fighting Doctor Strange and using the power of math. You know, I mean, he fought somebody that's wildly more powerful than he was, but using his mind, he was able to figure it out. And then how he was able to figure out how to heal Dr. Octopus. You know, that was cool.
Yeah.
And then also he took over Dr. Octopus's arms. Now, granted, some of that was the start tech, but he did think fast in order to do that. You know, once he saw the Bluetooth, he's like, oh, let's go. Then leading the spider team, that was really cool there, because, you know, you get these two other Spider-Men that are much more experienced. Well, I don't know. I guess they're not much more experienced.
No.
He's done a lot.
This real fight. Nick Fury said, he said, bitch, you've been to space.
Right, exactly. I guess he's done a lot. But for him to be able to say, like, listen, I've been a part of a team. You know, I was in the Avengers. Look, are you in a band? That was great. But for him to come through and say, all right, here's what we need to do, guys. I thought that was really cool, you know, for them to give him that leadership there. Last couple things, Tom Holland's acting was great too. Like right after Aunt May died, I gotta admit, I did tear up with that. The main reason I teared up is because I had recently just watched, it was either Comic Storian or Comic Explain or some other YouTube channel, and they were talking about the death of Gwen Stacy, and they were reading that scene. I had never heard it read, and in that scene, Spider-Man is talking to Gwen's dead body. He's like, what are you doing, Gwen? Like, I saved you. Come on, wake up. What are you doing? Like, the denial is there. Mm-hmm. And that's the same thing that you see in this scene. And it was amazing. It's like, he wasn't saying, oh God, Aunt May. He's like, May, what are you doing? What are you doing, May?
What's going on? Yeah, wake up. Why are you doing? What's wrong?
You okay?
Yeah.
You know, and it's like, the denial was just beautiful, man. It really made you feel for what he was going through. Like, gosh, man, gosh.
That, real quick, with that scene, that I like how they brought Happy in to, like, have another moment in that scene, because, like, you know, that's his basically girlfriend, I guess, in a way. You know, right. But then kind of seeing that closure with him and Peter, just eye contact. Then see her cry, her tear cry when he has to leave because he gets right. shot, you know. He has to run. Like, what? This is a scene. Like, dang, this is like only been like an hour or something in the movie. I'm like, gracious.
Our boy Gabe called it. He said that somebody's about to die right now. And sure enough, our maid caught it. and then the last thing with him meeting Ned and MJ after everything was over, that I thought that was a beautiful scene. I thought it was very well acted. And you could see all the emotion, particularly between MJ and Peter, and how she just kind of had this something. And you could tell he wanted so bad to tell her what was going on, but him to realize they're probably better without me, you know. And gosh, that was such an amazing scene. It was very well acted, and kudos to Tom Holland and kudos to the writers and directors for bringing that part to us. All right, so I'm throwing it back to you, sir. What other things do you like?
Oh, on that part, it was funny because I had a thought. After watching it, and then my son Christian.
Uh-oh. Time out, you're frozen.
Forget him. I'm like, you know, that's what I was thinking. Like, just you, make quick one video. All right, guys.
Time out. Stop. Stop. You get frozen. What? Yeah, you said, yeah, you were frozen for a good minute. You said that you saw that scene and then your son said, and that's when you kind of stopped. So I guess just start when you started talking.
Okay.
At that part. That's the first thing you said.
Okay.
Count
yourself
in. Two,
yep. Three. Yeah, also at the part that when he was trying to talk to them to kind of, I guess, tell them who he was. Like, me and my son both had the same question. Like, why don't you just take a video real quick of Ned and all them, just have them talking so they'll know that he's telling the truth, and then they can just, you know, he can just say what happened and everybody kind of starts working that out. But then I was like, you know, I think it was better him kind of giving Peter a fresh start and not having anybody know who his identity is, and kind of that's definitely more accurate. That's, you know, comic book accurate. Nobody knows who he is. Even Mary Jane, well, I guess it's gonna be Michelle Jones, and Ned, you know, so I guess that's kind of, they're gonna just start a whole fresh thing on the Spider-Man 4. Or I guess this was the closure of the trilogy.
Right.
Spider-Man and No Way Homes and all the home stuff that they did.
Right.
So now we'll get a little more of Spider-Man all by himself. I kind of want to see
that. Spider-Man all by himself. That's the name of the next one.
Spider-Man all alone.
Like Home Alone. I don't think that the video would have worked because, like, remember, the whole thing was that there was footage of Mysterio saying that Peter Parker killed him. So that didn't work.
Yeah,
so, very few people have addressed this.
Yeah,
but they have. It's interesting that right in Daredevil comics, like right now, like for whatever reason, they're doing a story very similar to that, where they made everybody forget Daredevil's secret identity. And one thing about that is that it wasn't a spell, it was like pheromones that was just passed across the world, I believe. And the thing about it is, like, when you read something, you know, like this bill that I have here, well, when I look at the bill, it's like, oh, I don't know what that is, so I'm not gonna pay it, you know. It's like, that's basically what it is. So I think, like, when you see the video, you won't see anything. Like, this literally in the comics right now, Kingpin picked up a piece of paper that has Daredevil's secret identity. It's like it's written right there. But when he picks it up, the paper's blank.
Okay. Yeah. You know, magic. I hate magic, you know? Like Michelle, like MJ. I hate magic. Yeah, magic sucks.
The other thing about it, about that part too, is the fact that not only did it seem like their lives would be better, but can you imagine him trying to explain that? Like, he's this guy that they don't know at all, you know, and he's like, hey, by the way, like, you guys know me. We went to school together, you know, and think about MJ. MJ's pretty cynical. So she didn't be like, yeah, get away from me, you weirdo.
Yeah.
You know, and then
him
being Spider-Man.
He's telling all the stuff we know about her.
yeah, exactly. You know, and then him, you know, being Spider-Man. Well, Spider-Man murdered Mysterio, you know, so they do know that. You know, so it's like, wait a second, you're the guy that murdered Mysterio. So I don't think that would have gone way well in any way.
They need to fix that, though. I'm serious. Like, I mean, it ain't gonna be too hard for Nick Fury and S.H.I.E.L.D. and them just to go ahead and fix that Mysterio thing. Like, Mysterio, you know, just somebody to give some information on Mysterio, who he was. I'm like, he's this person. He was no superhero. But then, I guess they got the Foxx News shunts going on with Jameson. He don't really care about facts. He's just there to get his point across.
That's a perfect example, sir. That's real life. We can't agree on anything. We can't even agree to protect ourselves from this disease that's murdering.
Or a face mask.
You're right, exactly.
Taking your freedoms.
My freedoms! I'll never die to it. Socialism? Let me give a shout out to the other two Spider-Man real quick here. Andrew Garfield, man, when he first showed up, how everybody went crazy. That was so amazing. Cause it's like, you know, when you first see Spider-Man from a distance, like, okay, they found Tom. But then when he turns around, it's like, wait a second, this is weird. Like, why is he turning around like that? Like that? That ain't Tom Holland.
That ain't Tom. We all blanky and stuff.
Yeah. And then let me see here. When he was hanging from the ceiling and then the grandmother made him go.
Oh, that part, bro. Crawling across the web. He's like crawling around over there. It's like, I like how they gave your boy some some redemption with the save on MJ. That was a touching moment too. It's like just kind of hit that part and you just thought about, like, it just brings you back to the scene, because I'm sorry to say that's one of the worst scenes, like the heart-wrenching type scenes I've ever seen on a movie. What are they doing? What are they gonna do with the Venom thing?
The symbiote?
Like, yeah.
I just want to say that you and I both agree on this. I definitely like what they did with that. Like, they pulled Venom in. Like, yeah, it would have been interesting to see him be a part of it, but I think it was much better for him just to show up and disappear like he did, because as you and I both have talked about, Tom Hardy does not make a good villain for Tom Holland. He just doesn't, because Venom is supposed to be basically like Spider-Man, maybe just a little bit bigger, you know, possibly a couple years older, but this is a grown-ass man.
I got a feeling that if they're going to use Tom Hardy as him, but they're going to change him, he's going to be a different type of Tom. He's not going to be like the chill, you know, I'm going to just, you know, kind of look like a hobo, you know, type of reporter. Like, he's going to probably be somebody you dislike and be trying to really get at Peter. Like, you know, try to undercut Peter a lot. Like, to me, they got to make him more of a villain type. So when he gets that symbiote, he's like, has a reason to go after Spider-Man.
Okay.
You know? So, like, you know, so they can bring him in there, because, I mean, it ain't nothing but the multiverse. It could be another Eddie Brock, just, you know, in New York or wherever the Daily Bugle is going to be at. I mean, they got all the other stuff there. So, you know, I don't think it's a big deal. Got to keep it pure.
Oh man, well, what do you guys think? What do you think about this amazing movie? Is this the best Spider-Man movie? Is it the best MCU movie? Is it one of the best MCU movies? Is it one of the best movies of all time? What do you guys think? We really, 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 really want to know. Please leave your comments here and let us know. And of course, you've got to subscribe. This is Color Commentary. We give you views from a different side.
Oh, man, no!
Saturday morning.